Hello, enjoy our adventure. My name is Martin Studer, my wife Sarah Studer, and we are going to be showing you our trip all around the northern New South Wales, as well as a bit of southern Queensland. I hope you enjoy our trip, and you'll see how we go along the way. Hello, welcome to episode 2. This episode, we'll be travelling from Ballandean to Walcha via Gyra, Yarralla and Armidale. Early in the morning, at sub-zero temperatures, we got up and had quite a delicious breakfast. I took this time to take my first opportunity to put on my thermals. After that I was not cut out to be a ballerina, we went out and checked out the globe during the day, where we viewed the skies at night. We then travelled to Wollongarra, one of the highest railway stations in Queensland, which is a lovely old station. You can see here some of the things that we had a look at, as well as that lovely sign out there that I had to do something about immediately. Wollongarra is also the place where you cross the border from Queensland into New South Wales. While I come from New South Wales and Sarah originally landed here in Queensland, a certain amount of rivalry has always developed, but it is mostly friendly. We then took off on the road and headed south.
Pretty cold. It's just getting on lunchtime, and it's no more than 10 degrees. In fact, it's sub 10. We'll be having lunch in Armidale. It's quite a lovely little town here. I do like Gyra. Famous for there's quite a few things. Famous for being bloody cold for starters. Famous for the Gyra ghost. Famous for all that poltergeist activity and business. You can look that up online if you feel like it. Also famous for the Gyra UFO crash, which turned out to be nothing more than a meteorite, but it scared the hell out of a lot of people at the time. Anyway, here we are. It's a lovely little town, and going to have a bit of a walk around. Slipping notes under the desk. Well, I was thinking about her dress. I was shy, turned away before she caught my eye. Go a bit of shopping. Sarah's back is really giving her a bit of trouble, so we're going to spend a little bit of time here, a bit of R&R before the last leg down to Walcha via Yarralla. Armidale's quite a nice place. It's very, very beautiful. I've always liked coming here, especially some of the parks. It's a university town, which is always nice. It's always struck me as being a little bit pretentious, though. The bit of the snobby older brother to Tamworth's more down-to-earth sort of cowboy hat-wearing person. But for all of that, Armidale is a very, very pretty town. There are many, many architectural and gardening things here that are just really quite nice, and I do love visiting here. So anyway, I'm quite hungry, so we're going to go off and have something to eat.
Armidale had a surprising number of memorials, including this particular wall for those suffering from child sexual abuse. I took some other photographs as we were going along, and something of Armidale rubbed off on me, and I had a bit of a go at taking some artsy kind of photos myself. Whether or not I succeeded is entirely up to the viewer. However, as we went along, we cleared up and we had a bit of lunch, and then we got on back into the bikes, and we headed off to Somera's homestead, which is just outside of Armidale. It is a squatter-era homestead, and it's quite a historical museum. It was closed for the winter while we were there, but we were allowed to go around the grounds and have a bit of a look.
I was once like you are now, and I know that it's not easy to be calm when you found something going on. But take your time, think a lot. I think of everything you've got, for you will still be here tomorrow, but your dreams may not. How can I try to explain? When I do, he turns away again. It's always been the same, same old story. I know that I have to go away. I know I have to go.
All right, we're in Urella, Thunderbolt Country. Behind me is a statue of the famous bush ranger, Captain Thunderbolt. He robbed to the rich and gave to himself. He was an absolutely fantastic guy. He also actually did quite a lot for the community of Urella, so I'm told. So he's a bit of a folk hero around this place and all around the New England. There's a bit of a museum about him, so we might even go there if we've got a little bit of time. It's getting a bit late in the day now. We're off to have yet another cup of coffee because we love our coffees. And yeah, it's going to be absolutely wonderful. I keep on saying the word wonderful, and wonderful is what this trip is. Welcome to Thunderbolt's Rock. This is the rocks that you can see behind me. This used to be the hideout of the legendary Captain Thunderbolt. He would hang out around these rocks, and the road's just down there. While he hung out around the rocks, he'd wait until a Cobb & Co. coach or another former stagecoach would come along, and then he'd swing down from the rocks and say, your money or your life. The rocks have been terribly, terribly graffitied over the years, and in fact some of this graffiti predates the first time I ever came here, which was like 40 years ago. So as a result, some of this graffiti is probably archaeological graffiti these days. But I always like coming out here, thinking about old Captain Thunderbolt and some of his legendary exploits.
Life ended fairly sadly, but fairly predictably for Fred Ward, aka Captain Thunderbolt. He was shot and killed outside of a town called Kentucky in 1870, but his monuments and his memories still remain.
He
then took a ride to Walcha, which was fairly uneventful. But we stayed the night there and prepared for the next day's worth of travel. See you then.